Collecting heat is one thing, but storage and delivery is another. I used a drain back system for my solar heating system. In this system, there is no water in the solar panels unless the pumps are running. Once the pumps come on, the panels fill with water, and when the water reaches the top, it runs back downhill to the tank. When the pumps shut off, the water drains out of the piping and back into the tank, so there's no water left in the panels at night. For the water storage tank, I began by digging a large hole, building a box in the hole, and after giving the insulation a good check, I insulate the box with 4 to 6 inches of foam. The box is lined with a felt liner before installing an EPDM pond liner to hold the water. A 30-foot square pond liner weighs over 400 pounds, so get some humans to help you out with it. I also lined the top of the box with a pond liner, and after it was carefully heaved in place, I insulated the lid with both foam and fiberglass insulation. Inside the box, you can see how I used large stainless washers and a lot of screws to hold the pond liner to the lid. You also see the suction port for the pump, the heat exchanger for the radiant floor heating system, and various tubes for placing temperature probes into the tank. Once the access port is sealed up, the only opening is just large enough to put a garden hose into the tank. Because the water in the storage tank can hit 160 degrees, a mixing valve is used to lower the water temperature entering the radiant floor system down to 120 degrees. Water leaving the storage tank passes through PEX tubing insulated with foam and covered with PVC pipe to keep the groundwater from contacting the PEX. This trench also carries a power cable to operate the pumps. The radiant floor system is composed of a pump and 1,000 feet of PEX tubing stapled up using aluminum heat distribution panels. There are better distribution panels on the market, but you can make these yourself using aluminum flashing. Finish this by placing a layer of insulation a couple inches below the PEX tubing so you drive the heat up through the floor. And there you have it, a heat storage tank and distribution system. I chose a 4,000 gallon water tank so I could store enough heat to span 4 or 5 cloudy days. I hope someday to add enough solar panels to collect double my daily heat requirements. The first 12 panels provided 50% of our heat for the first 2 winters. We are now up to 20 panels, and anticipate approximately 80% of our winter heat will come from the sun.